reference to the microphones.
Cameras, there is no truth to the allegation that there is some sort of collusion between the Trump campaign and Russia.
All right, this as three former campaign aides are volunteering to testify in front of that committee. One of them, Roger Stone, and he's speaking out today, defending his controversial contact with an online hacker. Last week, Stone admitted to communicating with Guccifer 2.0, an online outfit who claims responsibility for hacking the Democratic National Committee. Nevertheless, Stone continues to deny any collusion with the Russian government.
The inference my communication, actually my exchange with Guccifer 2, which is entirely on Twitter, both public and private, and which I have now made entirely public, constitutes collusion with the Russians is absurd. Number one, I don't concede that Guccifer is a Russian agent. Go online. There are more theories about that.
Our intelligence officials believe he was.
I understand. They also said there were Hussein had weapons of mass destruction. Just because the intelligence services say something, as we know from history, does not make it true.
So you're confident these investigations are going to turn up no information that contradicts your account?
Well, let's finish with Guccifer. My communication with him is now entirely public. It is benign.
All right, panel is back with us now, Jeffrey Lord and Robert Zimmerman. So, Robert, let me begin with you. Roger Stone says he is being completely transparent. And when he does go before that committee, what would the questions be that you would have for him?
You know, I have to tell you, if they were filming a movie about dirty tricksters, they would cast Roger Stone in the Joe Pesci role. He's a wannabe, basically, who wears a tattoo of Richard Nixon on his back. I mean, the big question, of course, is not only is why is Roger Stone talking to Guccifer in the first place? What is the rationale? How did he know that John Podesta was going to be in trouble? Let's be clear. When Rens Priebus says, as he just did in that clip you showed, that he's perfectly comfortable with Chairman Nunes's Intelligence Committee conducting hearings, of course he is, because Chairman Nunes is bringing his information down to the White House and showing it to the president. That was clear this week.
And he used to be on the transition team.
That's right. There's trust, absolutely. But there's not trust for an independent investigation. There's not trust for Chairman Nunes to conduct himself in a professional manner. That's why you've got people like John McCain and Congressman Adam Schiff calling for an independent investigator. And quite frankly, we need a special prosecutor.
And so, Jeffrey, you know, Roger Stone was also saying that, you know, intel is wrong, that this Guccifer 2 is not a, you know, Russian asset. Is he going into this already disparaging U.S. intelligence? Is that a problem?
Yeah, well, I don't know. You know, the thing is, Roger, I've known Roger Stone for decades, and I know he's controversial, but I can tell you one thing Roger is not, and he's not treasonous. That for sure. He is the ultimate patriot. You can agree or disagree with him, but committing treason is never something that Roger Stone would do, number one. Number two, a bit of news here. I was contacted last night by one of these individuals, Carter Page, who sent me a letter that he is now.
He's also volunteered to testify.
Yes, and he was asking Congressman Schiff, it's an open letter to Congressman Schiff and Congressman Nunes, asking that he be testified, that he testify. He says he's been defamed, and I have had that published today at spectator.org, which is the website for the American Spectator. So he is very insistent that he wants to be called, as I think Roger Stone is as well, and Paul Manafort. So it'll be very interesting, and frankly, I think they ought to really open this wide open. Find out who we're doing the leaks here. Let's get all those Obama folks, President Obama himself. Let's get everybody in here. John Podesta, who allegedly had ties to Russians. Let's get the whole barrel in there and see what's in it.
So Carter Page.